Good afternoon. Welcome to the Daytona Beach Area Coalition Community Event. Thank you for joining us to discuss this important initiative. This presentation will provide a brief overview of the study being conducted. At the end of the presentation, you can visit the exhibits, talk to staff, and provide input and comments. The Florida Department of Transportation has been looking at improvement needs along State Road A1A in Flagler and Volusia counties. We are starting with a segment in Volusia County and also including some of the major cross streets like East ISB, Main Street, Oak Ridge Boulevard, and Seabreeze Boulevard. We have a number of projects currently ongoing along these corridors. Oak Ridge Boulevard from Halifax Avenue to State Road A1A is under construction. East ISB between Halifax Avenue and State Road A1A is in final design and right-of-way purchase phase. We have a 3R, resurfacing, restoration, and rehabilitation project coming up along State Road A1A between East ISB and Seabreeze Boulevard. We wanted to look at all these projects collectively and identify corridor enhancement opportunities for this area. These projects provide immediate opportunities to implement some of the recommendations that will come out of this study. The purpose of this study is to develop a coalition of public and private stakeholders, develop a shared vision for key transportation corridors, seek community input on travel options. That's what we will be doing today. Based on your input, we will develop concepts and implementation strategies. Here are the project partners: City of Daytona Beach, City of Holly Hill, Lodging and Hospitality Association of Volusia County, River to Sea Transportation Planning Organization, Volusia County, and VOTRAN. We also have stakeholders like Boardwalk at Daytona Development, Beachside Neighborhood Watch, Plaza Resort, Daytona Regional Chamber, and Sons of the Beach. Members of the public are also critically important to the study. We'd like to hear from everyone in this community, whether you're here to live, work, learn, or play. Understanding the land use of the study area is important to find the right transportation solutions. As you can see, the land use immediately adjacent to the study corridors is primarily commercial, shown in red color. We also have governmental uses shown in gray color. There is also a substantial amount of residential uses within the area, shown in yellow color. We will be mindful of these land uses as we develop context-sensitive solutions for the corridors. The project team conducted safety and traffic analyses. Improving bicycle pedestrian safety is one of our key goals of the study. We will also enhance mobility of all modes and users along the study corridors. The signalized intersections are critical nodes as they control traffic flows in the corridors. Pedestrian crossings are also very important from a safety perspective. There was a total of 711 crashes in the study area between 2013 and 2018. Approximately 91% are auto crashes, and the remaining 9% are bicycle pedestrian crashes, which is very high. From a crash severity perspective, over 99% of the crashes are either injury crashes or property damage only. Less than 1% are fatal crashes, approximately 7 in 5 years. Although the number may seem small, one fatality is one too many. FDOT adopted Vision Zero Traffic Safety Initiative, and we are doing everything we can to reach that target. This slide is showing the crash patterns. The red triangles are pedestrian crashes, yellow squares are bike crashes, and green circles are vehicular crashes. Most of the pedestrian crashes are concentrated at the intersections. We also highlighted the intersections with high crash rates with yellow circles. Out of 711 total crashes in the study corridors, 561 happened at the intersections. The pie chart is showing that approximately 91% is auto crashes and 9% is bicycle pedestrian related crashes at the intersection. The table shows number of crashes by intersection and which ones are critical. 6 intersections have crash rates higher than critical crash rates. This will be an important consideration during concept development. The project team also analyzed traffic level of service. On a typical weekday, the intersections operate acceptably. You see letter grades A, B, C, and D on the slide. Those are similar to a grading system used in school. A is the best and F is the worst. Anything worse than D is unacceptable. Level of service becomes an issue on major event days like Daytona 500 and Daytona Bike Week. We will be considering event traffic management in our concepts. In our concepts, we intend to capture the community vision for these corridors. Obviously, we will address the safety and mobility issues. We also would like to make the corridors aesthetically pleasing with landscaping and beautification features. During the open house after this presentation, we will present some options and get your ideas on what you'd like to see in these corridors. You will see concept drawings like this one on the boards and on the tables. Staff will explain the concepts and answer any questions you may have. You will also see before and after three-dimensional renderings of the corridors. Here's an existing view of a segment of A1A. Here's how we plan to enhance the corridor. Note the wider sidewalks, planter beds with flowers, and enhanced landscaping. Delivery vehicles often block traffic flow along A1A. The smart delivery zones you see on the slide will provide space for these vehicles to load and unload, which will relieve congestion. When the delivery zones are not being used, they can be repurposed for pedestrian use. The bollards, or posts, will separate the space from traffic. This is a view of existing Oak Ridge Boulevard before construction started. This is a three-dimensional rendering of the Oak Ridge Boulevard project under construction now. As you can see, we are adding enhanced corridor features like green bike lane and landscaping. We are also implementing innovative treatments like the Zikla Zipper System. The Zikla Zipper System has been extensively used in Spain. These plastic modules protect cyclists and prevent vehicles on the road from invading the bike lane. They are highly visible because 50% of the surface is retroreflective. We are considering a number of innovative treatments along the corridors. You can see pictures of smart lighting, raised intersections, high-emphasis pedestrian crosswalk lighting, in-pavement lighting, beautification features, and the Zikla Zipper System. We are also considering using retractable or removable bollards or posts to control traffic flow during events. Concrete bollards or posts can be used to protect pedestrians at high crash intersections. After we hear from you today, we will develop our final concepts, recommendations, and implementation plans. Our next community event will be held in the fall. We will share more specifics soon. With that, enjoy the open house. We look forward to talking with you at the various stations around the room. If you have any questions or would like to discuss anything after today's community event, please feel free to contact Stephen Buck with the Florida Department of Transportation. His contact information is provided on the slide. Thanks, everyone. Have a good evening.